to another Flickchat Quick Peeks. A little bit different to the normal programming, but don't worry, still us talking bollocks about films that we've watched.
Good old bollocks.
Yes, you can't beat a bit of bollocks.
Aye.
This week, we've been watching From Beyond the Grave.
Well, what's it about?
From Beyond the Grave is a 1974 British anthology film from Amicus Productions, directed by horror director Kevin Connor, produced by Milton Subotsky, and based on stories by R. Chedwin Hayes. It was the last in a series of anthology films from Amicus and was preceded by Dr. Terror's House of Horrors in 1965, Torture Garden in 1967, The House That Dripped Blood in 1970, Asylum in 72, Tales from the Crypt 1972 also, and The Vault of Horror in 1973. Originally this film was known as The Undead. It is also known as The Creatures, Tales from Beyond the Grave, and Tales from the Beyond. It's about four customers who purchase, or take in some matters, things from the Temptations Limited, an antique shop whose motto is, offers you cannot resist, a nasty fate awaits those who cheat the shop's proprietor, played by Peter Cushing. So, as you can say it by the 70s horror film, it's Peter Cushing. You can immediately thinking, well, hang on, that sounds just like a Hammer film, which has been covered by the our production company.
Yep.
Come on, you might as well plug you.
All right, yeah, the Hammer homages, which are one day going to come back, one day. But I have been meaning to watch stuff from Amicus because these were kind of like one of the many Hammer rip-off companies that came out around about that time, because obviously Hammer had their massive successes with like Curse of Frankenstein, Dracula, and all the other top films that they put out. So other British studios came along and thought, well, I want a piece of that. So, and Amicus was one of them, and I've been meaning to watch some of their work to see how it tots up with the state, the big guns that are
Hammer. The pun, the steak.
Yeah, that and the pun, yes, that Hammer is. So this was a long overdue thing for me, really.
It's you can see why it, well, I thought anyway, why it wasn't as popular as the Hammer films, because it's just bloody weird. Where Hammer, it was very simple. It was sort of dingy 17th century castles in faraway lands.
It was just the Hammer stuff is just very gothic. I mean, this did have its gothic tones too. There was a couple of moments where there was some quite good atmospheric pieces, and they took a lot of cues from the Hammer things with the light in the eyes and things like that, which again,
slightly under the chin camera shots.
Yeah, exactly. And you could see where they were taking little cues and taking that sort of gothic horror element, but it was very much a modern day piece. Well, a modern day piece of the 70s.
Well, obviously.
Modern 70s.
A few famous faces pop up. There's a few that you recognise. I think I'm sure I've seen him somewhere.
Yeah.
Ooh, it wasn't she in what's his name?
Yeah.
But familiar, David Warner's in there, old Bob Cratchit from George C. Scott's A Christmas Carol.
Of course, Peter Cushing's there as well.
Mm-hmm. My favourite character in it had to be, what was her name? Madame something.
Oh, the really weird psychic lady. Yeah.
She looked like one of the teachers from Hogwarts, the astronomy teacher from Hogwarts.
Yeah.
But she was just weird and out there, and she was all, ooh, hello.
But what exactly is...
An elemental? Oh, it's a spirit of air, fire, and water. An invisible, bodiless creature which lusts after the pleasures of the flesh. It sucks the very juices of the soul. Let us inspect this friend of yours. Oh, dear. Oh, he is firmly embedded.
This was one of those... It was
a weird sitting.
It was more like an experiment for me, this. Like I said, it was just an excuse to see one of the other studios trying to be Hammer, and yeah, it kind of, as I said, it had a few interesting little moments.
It's an acquired taste.
Yeah, it had a few interesting moments, like I said, with the atmospheric pieces, and there were one or two nice bits of camera work in this, particularly in the first story where they were doing the seance, and it focuses on a candle, and it's sort of like doing a circular motion round the table, keeping the candle in the middle of the shot, and I thought that was quite an interesting piece of camera work there. But other than that, there wasn't really much more to it, and it got very boring quite quickly, and I lost interest very quickly.
It's definitely one of them. I think if you're a fair weather Hammer fan, if you're only really aware of, I would say really, if you're only aware of the Dracula stuff,
yeah.
If you're not really aware that they did, you know, multiple werewolf films,
yeah.
Carried on with different subjects away from the gothic horror,
yeah.
You're probably not going to enjoy From Beyond the Grave, because it's very, no. It's really, for me, I thought it was very, very out there.
But yeah, it wasn't that memorable for me. It was just one of those, I've watched it, I've seen it, and
tick it off the bucket.
Yeah, I can tick it off my list now. I've seen an Amicus one, and I'm thinking, yeah, I probably won't watch anymore. It's kind of like, it's one of those, it's a sort of thing, me personally, it's a sort of thing that probably would have inspired sort of the format of the Treehouse of Horrors from The Simpsons.
Well, yeah, and you can see, I even read a quote of somebody saying, this was Hellraiser before Clive Barker could read.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I mean, obviously Clive Barker as well, to listen to him, he isn't, but he is a Scouser. Let's not deny that, he is a British Liverpudlian. But this is sort of, you can see where Hellraiser is very American in its approach, very, you know, big budget, everything's on a large scale. This is basically like a very sort of British civilized Hellraiser, if you like the whole the Hellbound Heart. It's a collection of stories. This is what this was.
Yeah.
But it's, like I say, it's one of them. I don't think I'll be watching it again. I tend to watch it every 15 years or so. So I've seen it twice now.
Yeah. So. Yeah, final thoughts.
Interesting film, but not one you can watch again and again.
No. They have a lot of good ideas, but not executed very well, is my opinion.
No.
And I probably won't watch it again. That was from Beyond the Grave.
The Grave.
That's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Just my little joke.
I'm a ghost.